Hello and good afternoon. Welcome to another episode of Fact vs. Fiction. I'm Archis, and today we are going to be discussing how a fight between two individuals over a parking lot turned into a riot-like situation in Old Delhi. Now, this incident was fueled up by a series of misinformation that was spread against both the Hindu and the Muslim communities of that area through WhatsApp. Now, we have with her Nivedita on Skype here, who is one of our reporters and who took the trouble of going all the way to Delhi and speaking to the locals to find out what really happened. Hi, Nivedita. So this started off as a fight between two individuals, as we saw, a person called Sanjeev Gupta and Aas Mohammed. And suddenly we get reports of temples and mosques being vandalized and people attacking each other with weapons to a point that we didn't really know which part of it was true or which part of it wasn't. So when you went over there to Delhi and spoke to the locals, what did you find out exactly? What was the chain of events that eventually led to the situation?
So for 3 days, Hauz Qazi in Chawri Bazaar of Old Delhi was on the brink of a communal riot. There were fights between both the communities. It all started with a parking fight between Sanjeev Gupta and Aas Mohammed at 9:30 p.m. on Sunday night. They had a fight about who, when Aas Mohammed tried to park his bike and Sanjeev Gupta objected because the area was right opposite his house. So that fight led to both the parties beating each other up. That is Sanjeev Gupta and Aas Mohammed beating each other up. This should have ended right then and there. But between 9:30 and 11:30, after the parking fight was done and dusted, a lot of Muslims in the area received screenshots like you see on screen right now, saying that a 20-year-old Muslim boy had been lynched to death. The area is a majority Muslim population, and most of them received such messages and also calls that a Muslim boy had been killed by a Hindu family. So all the Muslims gathered in front of the police station, Hauz Qazi police station, to protest the lynching, which they believed to be true. It was as this protest was going on at 11:30, this protest went on till 11. They all stood outside the police station, chanted Allahu Akbar, and you know, they were just very angry about this lynching. Between 11:30 and 12:04, a part of the people protesting outside the police station have reached this mandir. It's a shrine in a lane called Gali Durga Mandir, temple, and pelted stones at it. These are youngsters who've gone there and they've pelted stones and vandalized some of the statues. Incidentally, this temple is right opposite Sanjeev Gupta's house, basically right opposite the place where the parking fight happened. They pelted stones at it. Now, when this was done, the Hindus in the area got very visibly angry. And while they did not do anything then and there, a lot of Hindus in the area after this started receiving messages that hamare mandiro ko maar giraya hai, jalaya hai, and that the Hindu women have been beaten by Muslim men. So when we went there, a lot of Hindus told me that Muslims came to the temple with guns and they set fire to the temples, they entered houses, threatened women, which was not true. We have CCTV footage which shows that they only pelted stones. They did nothing more. They didn't have weapons on them. They didn't enter houses. They just pelted stones at the temple and vandalized some of the statues. Now, this happened at about 12:40. There's CCTV footage of that. By 2 o'clock in the night, there were messages that were sent again to Hindus claiming, what kind of Hindus are you who are not protesting this vandalization, protesting the abuse that our women had to face? This led to more anger among the Hindus, wherein they were like, okay, yes, so much has happened. You need to know that this is just in one lane. It's not like a visible temple for the main road. So it gets very difficult to ascertain whether they entered homes or no, but this message fueled anger among the Hindus. Again, now the Hindus are angry because the temple has been vandalized. The Muslims are angry because they believe that a 20-year-old youngster has been killed by the Hindu families. Now at 4 a.m., with the police at the spot, with them trying to, you know, make peace between the communities, not let it grow into a riot-like situation, at 4 a.m., Muslims in the area start receiving messages and calls again that Fatehpuri Masjid and Lal Masjid. These are two masjids in the area, in the vicinity of the temple, about 10 minutes away from each other. That these two masjids have been pelted with stones, that Hindus are pelting stones on these masjids. This again angered the Muslims. So a series of fake messages plus inflammatory messages and you know giving anger gave rise to anger in both the communities. While it was all it was a parking fight, which became a lynching and then led to a temple being vandalized, and then it became a fake message of the masjids were vandalized by the Hindus.
Okay. So just to go through things, the only things that did happen was the fight happened between the two individuals and people protested against it at the police station, and there was some pelting of stones at the Durga temple in the lane, as you said. Yes. Everything else was just made up. And so what role did social media and WhatsApp had in all of this?
So WhatsApp played a big role, and also did Facebook. We spoke to this group of youngsters who did instant fact checking at the during these 3 days. So they run this Facebook page called Purani Dilli Walo Ki Baate, which is a heritage page to bring out the culture of the area. They since it's a very popular page, they started receiving messages and information from across Delhi, from people, from their followers across Delhi, saying this is happening in in Hauz Qazi. What do you have to say about it? How is this happening? And these two youngsters, like you see on screen, is Rahim, Mohammed Rahim, and his friend Abu Sufyan. They went to each and every place. If there was a message claiming Fatehpuri Masjid has been pelted with stones, they went to Fatehpuri Masjid and spoke to the Imam to show that the Fatehpuri Masjid was completely fine. Again, at Lal Masjid, they went there and showed people that Lal Masjid was completely fine. No stones were being pelted. There were no Hindus trying to vandalize the masjid there. And these two told me that the messages were not just restricted to residents of Old Delhi. They were receiving messages, calls from various Muslims in Delhi itself, as mass forwards were reaching various Muslims saying Muslims are being beaten up in Hauz Qazi, Muslims are being killed in Hauz Qazi. And it's a majorly Muslim populated area, like I said. So such a message to do the rounds is very obvious that they would get angry.
So we have all seen how dangerous and nuanced fake news could be, and how important it is for people to come in and help. You know, we saw how citizens were fact-checking in this situation, and how this kind of may have helped the situation from getting even worse. So, for our viewers, you know, we would expect the same from you. If you come across such a situation, you know, do your best to fact-check it so that, you know, you can help the situation and not let it get worse. So, we're going to wrap this up today with that. That's all. And if you see more of such fake news going around, you know, that you doubt, please do send it over to us on our helpline number, you know, and we can do our bit and fact check it for you. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.